Hi everyone, so this is Ishmita here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we will be doing Act 2, Scene 2 of Merchant of Venice, Part 2. Okay, so let's carry on. Enter Bassanio with Leonardo and another follower or two. So Bassanio says to one of his follower or servant that you may do so, but let it be so hasted that supper be ready at the farthest by 5 o'clock. Now Bassanio here, he is ordering one of his servants that prepare all the things for the supper as fast as possible, that is before 5 o'clock, because everyone will come after that. So basically supper is the short meal before dinner. We take the short meal before the dinner. So in Act 1 also we got to know that he was inviting his friends for the supper. See these letters delivered. Put the liveries to making and desire Gratiano to come anon to my lodging. So now he is ordering the servant that deliver all the letters quickly and tell the servants put the liveries to making that servant uniforms. Send the servant uniforms to be designed quickly. And he says that also tell Gratiano to come see me quickly. Now after Bassanio gives the order to the servant, he leaves. Lancelot. To him, father. Now Lancelot, he is pointing towards Bassanio and telling his father that this is the man I was talking to you about. I am now willing to serve under him. Gobbo. Now Gobbo, he says to Bassanio that God bless you. So he is giving his blessings to Bassanio. Bassanio. Grimaci, would thou watch with me? So Bassanio says, thank you. Can I do anything, any favor for you? Gobbo. He is my son, sir, a poor boy. So now Gobbo, he mentions Lancelot and says that he is a poor boy, to which Lancelot immediately replies, not a poor boy, sir, but the rich Jew's man, that would, sir, as my father shall specify. So now as Gobbo, he mentioned Lancelot as a poor boy. Now Lancelot immediately says that I am not a poor boy. I serve for a rich Jew and now my father will explain you. Gobbo, he hath a great infection, sir, as one would say to serve. Now Gobbo is explaining that here infection, they want to say that very keen, very desired, that he is very desired to serve for you. Lancelot, indeed the short and the long is, I serve the Jew and have a desire as my father shall specify. So Lancelot is saying that in short, I will say that I basically serve the Jew and I want to and now I have a desire to serve under you and my father will explain you ahead. Gobbo, his master and he, saving your worship's reverence, are scarce kettle cousins. So here he is Lancelot and his master is Jew the Shylock the Jew. So here he says that Lancelot and Shylock, they hardly get along with each other. Lancelot, to be brief, the very truth is that the Jew, having done me wrong, doth cause me, as my father being, I hope, an old man, shall fruity unto you. So Lancelot says that in brief, basically Shylock, he does not treat me well, and my father will explain you further. Gobbo, I have here a dish of doves that I would bestow upon your worship, and my suit is. So in the beginning of this scene, that is Act 2, Scene 2, Part 1, we studied that Gobbo, he brought a basket along with him, which was a present to Shylock, who was a master of Lancelot. But since Lancelot does not want to serve him anymore and Bassanio will be the future master, so Gobbo presents that basket, that is the present to Bassanio. And what was inside the basket? Dish of doves. So this was a present. This is very important, dish of doves. Bestow upon your worship and my suit is, Lancelot. In very brief, the suit is impertinent to myself, as your worship shall know by this honest old man. And though I say it, though old man, yet poor man my father. So Lancelot says, in brief, the suit is basically the thing that Gobbo wanted to say, that it is related to me. And as you can tell by the honest man, and now he says that my father will explain you further. Bassanio, one speak for both. What would you? So basically, what was happening here? Goba and Lancer, they both were saying repetitive things in between, and they were saying very, 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 very little part. A little part Goba was saying, something Lancelot was saying. They were not coming main to the point. So Bassanio says that one person will speak for both of you, and please tell me what you want from me. Lancelot, serve you, sir. Goba, that is very defect of the matter, sir. So now they both come to the very point that we want to serve you. Lancelot. Bassanio, I know thee well. Thou hast obtained thy suit. So Bassanio is saying that I know that very well, and I grant you the position as my servant. Shylock, thy master spoke with me this day, and hath preferred thee, if it be preferment, to leave a rich Jew's service to become the follower of so poor a gentleman. So Bassanio says that yes, your master Shylock, he talked to me about you. So you remember when they were talking about when they were talking about the deal between Antonio and Shylock. So at the end, Shylock also said that I will go to my house and check, because I have left my house in the hands of an unworthy person. He was referring to Lancelot at that time. So Bassanio says that yes, your master Shylock, he spoke to me about you today only, and he preferred me. Now you can take it as your promotion. Maybe you can take it as your promotion because you are leaving a rich Jew's service and you are following me, that is Bassanio, who is a poor man. So he says that you might call it as a promotion. So Lancelot, the old proverb is very well parted between my master Shylock and you, sir. So now Lancelot is saying that there is an old proverb which will be very well suited for you and my master Shylock. That is, you have the grace of God, sir, and he hath enough. So what he wants to say is that here you is Bassanio. Lancelot wants to say that Bassanio, he has God's blessings. On the other hand, Shylock, he has enough and very much wealth. Bassanio, thou speaks it well. Go farther with thy son. So Bassanio is saying that you speak very well, and now he tells Gobo, that is Lancelot's father, to take his son and take the leave from the old master, that is Shylock, and inquire my lodging out and come back to my place. Now Bassanio, he says to one of his followers that give him a livery more guarded than his fellows, say it done. So he is saying that give him the uniform, and it should be more ornamented than the other followers. Lancelot, farther in, I cannot get a service. No, I have a near tongue in my head. So he says that, father, see, I can get a job on my own, and even I can speak for myself. Now he takes out his palm and he starts reading it on his own. Well, if any man in Italy have a fairer table with dots offered to swear upon a book, I shall have good fortune. So he says that any man in Italy, if he has to swear by keeping his hand on Bible, so the Christians, they do it usually like this only, they take oaths by keeping their hand on Bible. So he says that my luck will be the best, my fortune will be the best. Go to here's a simple line of life. So he points a line on his palm and says, see, this is the simple line of my life. Here's a small trifle of wives. So he says, here's a small unimportant line which refers to marriage. Alas, 15 wives is nothing. So he starts reading his hand on his own, and now he says, see, there is a line of 15 wives, but it is nothing. 11 widows and 9 maids is a simple coming in for one man. So he says 11 widows and 9 maids is a very good record for a single man. And then to escape drowning thrice and to be in peril of my life with the edge of a feather bed. Here are some simple escapes. So now as he reads his palm, what all things he mentions is that there is a line of life. Then there's an unimportant line of marriage, which refers to 15 wives, which he says is nothing much. Then he says 11 widows and 9 maids is a very good record for a single man. Then he says by reading his hand, he says that after all these things, I will be saved from drowning in water 3 times. Then my life will be in danger as I will fall from a feather bed. He says these are all simple small escapes from my life. Well, if fortune be a woman, she is a good wrench for this girl. So he says that if fortune, that if your luck is a woman only, then she is a very good fortune teller. Father, come, I will take my leave of the Jew in the twinkling. So he says, Father, let's come and I will take my leave from my old master, that is Shylock the Jew. Exit Lancelot, the clown with the old Gobbo. So Lancelot and Gobbo, they exit. Now, why the clown word here, it is used? Because Lancelot, he used to work as a jester for Shylock. So jester is not, we can say jester as a clown. It is basically the person who entertains by doing funny things. So basically a clown only. Bassanio, I pray thee, good Leonardo, think of this. These things being bought and orderly bestowed. Return in haste, for I do feast tonight my best esteemed acquaintance. Hie thee, go. So now Bassanio, he is saying to Leonardo. So Leonardo is one of his servants. He is saying that take all these things, wrap them up properly and keep them away and return back as fast as possible because I have planned a dinner with a very good friend of mine. So go fast and come back fast. So Leonardo, my best endeavors shall be done herein. Enter Gratiano. So Gratiano enters the scene. Gratiano is one of the friends of Bassanio. So Gratiano, he refers to Leonardo that where is your master? So here master is Bassanio. Because Leonardo, he was the servant of Bassanio. So that's why. Leonardo, yonder sir he walks. So Leonardo, he points towards Bassanio saying that he is walking over there. And then Leonardo, he exits. Gratiano, signia Bassanio. Bassanio, Gratiano. So basically they both are addressing to each other. Gratiano, I have a suit to you. So Gratiano is saying that I have a thing to ask from you. Bassanio, you have obtained it. I have already granted it to you. Gratiano, you must not deny me. I must go with you to Belmont. So he presents his suit and says that you will not refuse me and I will go with you to Belmont. So Bassanio, he was going to Belmont to woo Portia, as we got to know in Act 1, Scene 1 only. Bassanio, why then you must, but hear thee, Gratiano. Thou art too wild, too rude and bold of voice. So Bassanio says, so you want to accompany me. But listen, Gratiano, you are too wild, that is, you are too uncontrollable. You are very rude and bold of voice, that is, you do not know what you are speaking. Parts that become thee happily enough, and in such eyes as are appears not false. But where thou art not known, why there they show. So he says that over here among us, all the friends, these things are not considered as false. They are considered funny and like friendly. But the places where you are not known to someone else, they are considered as false because they don't know you. So you have to put a modest expression. Something too liberal, pray thee, take pain to ally with some cold drops of modesty. Thy skipping spirit let through thy wild behavior. I be miscounted in the place I go to and lost my hopes. So he says that if you come with me, you will have to show your modest behavior and you will not show your wild behavior over there. Because if you do all these things, then I will be misjudged over there and all my hopes will be shattered. Because he has to keep a good image over there. Gratiano, signia Bassanio, hear me, if I do not put on a sober habit, talk with respect and swear, but now and then. So he says that I promise you I will behave very soberly, I will talk with full respect and I swear if I do not do this, then you need not talk to me. Wear prayer books in my pocket, look demurely, nay more, while grace in saying hood mine eyes thus with my heart and say amen. So he says that I will carry prayer books along with me, and when we will have meal I will always pray and I will keep my heart down in front of them and say amen with my eyes closed. So all these things he is mentioning, that he will talk with respect, he will carry prayer books, he will close his eyes before having a meal and remember God, he will keep his heart in front of them as a bow of respect and say amen. So all these things he is mentioning that he will bring good in his attitude. Use all the observance of civility, like one well studied in sad ostent to please his grandma. Never trust me more. He says, I will show all the habits of a civilized society and I will do all the things in a way like you do to please your grandma. So in old times, like our grandmas, they always respect a very good behavior, like they are very strict with the behavior kind of things. So he says that it will be as if I am wanting to please my grandma with very modest behaviors. So I will behave very nicely. And he says that if I do not do all these things, you will never trust me ever again. Bassanio, well, we shall see you bearing. So he says, okay, I will see you how you will behave tonight. Gresciano, nay, but I bar tonight. You shall not gouge me by what we do tonight. So he says, no, you cannot do that. You cannot judge me by what I am doing tonight, because this is the last night together, as I will be going to Belmont the very next day. So he says that today I will be in my wildest mood. Bassanio, no, that were pity. I would entreat you rather to put on your boldest suit of mirth, for we have friends that purpose merriment. But fare you well, I have some business. So Bassanio is saying, no, that would be very pity to do so. I was just having fun. You can behave in your wildest mood today and enjoy your best, as we also have some friends of us to entertain. So you can do best as you can. Gresciano, and I must to Lorenzo and the rest, but we will visit you at the supper time. So as Bassanio was busy, Gresciano says, I will leave you alone as I have Lorenzo and others to meet, and we will meet you together at the supper time. And here this scene ends. So these are few questions from Act 2, Scene 2, complete Act 2, Scene 2. So please pause the video and do these questions. Thank you. Please do like and subscribe and turn on the post notifications. Bye.